बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामु अलैकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? दिस इज़ मी, योर मैथमेटिक्स टीचर। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न समथिंग न्यू अबाउट द फ्रैक्शन। इट इन्वॉल्व्स द रीडिंग ऑफ द फ्रैक्शन एंड द राइटिंग ऑफ द फ्रैक्शंस, और यू कैन से द डिवीजन सम्स इन वर्ड्स। बिकॉज बिफोर दैट यू हैव लर्न अबाउट द एडिशन, सब्ट्रैक्शन, मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड डिवीजन ऑफ फ्रैक्शंस। So today we are going to learn about that, if some fractions are given, so how to read them and how to write division sums in word form. So for writing that, first we need to know that how to read a fraction properly according to the place value of the numbers, or you can say the fractions. Okay, so let's see how do we read fractions. One numerator and two denominators, so that means it is one half. If denominator is one, denominator is 6 and the numerator is 1, so it is 1/6. See, 1/6, basically this half, sixth, third, they are telling about us the denominator. So this is the way of reading a fraction. So see over here, there is another, that if the numerator is 1 and denominator is 10, so that means this is 1/10. So whenever we are dealing these types of fractions and proper way of reading, basically it helps us also in fractions, and it also helps us to identify the decimal place values. So this will help you inshallah in learning of decimals as well. Here is another thing which will be discussed in this video, that what is the difference between the fractions if the numerator is 1 or if the numerator is more than 1. If the numerator is 1, so how do we read that fraction? So that is like if numerator is 1 and the denominator is 3, so it is 1/3. Okay, so see this, this is 1/3. So if the numerator is 2 and the denominator is 3, so this is 2/3. See the difference? 1/3, that was singular, okay, and 2/3, so it's, you know, in the plural form. So whenever we read the fractions, so be careful about these words. So you know, whenever we talk about the fractions and their place values and place values of the digits, so it helps us a lot if we are reading them properly. So 1/4, 3/4, 1/4, 3/4. So in the same way, 1/5 and 2/5. So see the difference. Now here is if we have double digit fraction. So what to do at that time? So of course we are going to, you know, read it also properly by its, you know, its numbers, and you know, by its place values of the numbers. So 15/20, okay. Why I'm talking about the place values, like these you're going to learn in the decimal chapter, that how this reading of fraction will help us in decimals. So 15/20, so we'll see there are a lot of ways to read a fraction. 15/20, 15 over 20, 15 divided by 20. So in any way you can read. Let's see now that what was our objective, that how to write a division sum in word form. So here is the question number 5 in your exercise. Copy and complete this table thinking very carefully. So let's see how to complete this table. An example given to you, the 2 divided by 1/3. So how to write it in word form? How many thirds? See, now this, basically this reading of fraction is helping us to write this in word form. So how many thirds make 2 wholes? Okay, see, how many thirds make 2 wholes? So how do we solve this? And we got quotient 1. Basically, we have taken the inverse of the fraction, and then, you know, after taking the reciprocal, we just did the normal division process to get this answer. So let's see how. A part. As you can see, A part over here, 3 divided by 1/7. See, 3 divided by 1 seventh. So now what is the word form of it? Exactly like your example, that how many, now this is 1 seventh. So that means how many sevenths will make, what is the whole number here? 3 wholes. See, basically they are asking you that how many sevenths altogether they'll make 3 wholes. So now we are going to find out that number, that quotient, that basically which is involved here in this question. So let's see how to find it out. If we go for the normal procedure of division of fractions, so what we do that? We are writing 1 under it and then 7 upon 1, the reciprocal of the second fraction. So 3 times 7, what is 3 times 7? It is 21. So that means my quotient is 21. So 21 sevenths altogether will make 3 wholes. Are you getting the point that 21 sevenths altogether will make 3 wholes? Let's see another example. 9 divided by 1 tenth. Okay, so what will be the word form of it? That how many? So now which is the fraction involved here? 1 tenth. So how many tenths make, what is the whole number involved here? 9 wholes. See how simple this is if you know how to read the fraction properly. Okay, so how many tenths will make 9 wholes? How many tenths? That how many tenths, how many times tenths we are going to write, and then we are getting this 9 wholes. So 10 times 9, that is 90, the shortcut way to get it. Okay, because we're talking about how many tenths make 9 wholes. If you cannot do it directly, you can follow the division process of fractions and then you can get your answer. So how many tenths will make 9 wholes? 90 tenths will make 9 wholes. C part, the quotient is already given to you. We just need to convert it into the word form. So what is the word form of it? What is the fraction here? 1 11th. So how many 11th make, what is the whole number involved here? 12 wholes. Okay, so the quotient is 132, because 12 times 11 is 132. The last question, that how many 12s will make 14 wholes? So you can multiply 14 and 12 to get your answer. So I hope you understand the concept of doing this, that how to write division sums in, you know, word form, and how to write the quotient for it. So how many 12s will make 14 wholes? 168. If you multiply these two, so you can get 168. And how many 12s? Just write it here. 12s. Erase it out. Let's see. Twelves make 14 wholes. Okay. So how many? 168 twelves will make 14 wholes. I hope you understand the concept of writing the division sums into words and to find out their quotient. Stay blessed and complete your work. Bye. Love is.